Hi, wrestling fans. Welcome to another action-packed, exciting hour of Smoky Mountain Wrestling. Wrestling the way it used to be and the way you like it. Hi again, I'm Bob Cottle, and we got a great hour in store for all of you fans this week. We're going to see Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff in action, along with the Rock and Roll Express. Tracy Smothers also will be here in action. We're going to be hearing from Tim Horner, Jim Cornette, and the Heavenly Bodies, and we'll have more matches that will be signed for Thanksgiving Thunder. And our big main event will be the Fantastics against the Stud Stable. That's our dream match. What were the signs you had there, Dutch? My tag partner, Dutch Mantell.
They were nothing. There's some pieces of scrap paper I had. Listen, folks, today on Down and Dirty with Dutch, I have an extended version today, and we're going to take an in-depth look at what happened to Brian Lee last week at the hands of the master who has later been revealed as Kevin Sullivan. And my special guest today will be Bob Armstrong, who will make an announcement. I believe something big is up, Bob.
Yeah, you're right. I'm sure a lot is going to happen. It'll be a big, big event. Hey, Nitro Danny Davis.
Hi, Danny. Bob. Just want all the Smoky Mountain wrestling fans to know that Nitro Danny Davis is alive and doing well. And please, just for me, stay tuned to today's program because we have a very special surprise for Paula Orndorff.
All right, fans, it's going to be a great hour. You stay right with us and we'll be ready. We'll have all the action right after we take this time out.
WYMZ invites you to attend Smoky Mountain Wrestling's Thanksgiving Thunder Thursday, November the 26th at Memorial Gym in Hazard. Jim Cornette's Heavenly Bodies defend the tag titles against the Rock and Roll Express and Falls Count anywhere in the building. Tim Horner faces the Dirty White Boy in a lumberjack match for the title. Kevin Sullivan faces the Mongolian Stomper returning to Hazard. A Pick the Winner Battle Royal. One lucky fan will win a portable stereo. Four more matches. Kids under 12 get in for only 57 cents. That's Thanksgiving night in Hazard.
Wrestling fans, introducing first from Reno, Nevada, 228 pounds, Reno Riggins.
Hey, what did Danny Davis say when he came out here?
He just said, stay tuned, and he's got a big surprise for all the fans, and especially a big surprise for Paul Orndorff. And I'm anxious to see what that's going to be.
Well, here he comes, fans. Mr. Orndorff, who has stirred quite a bit of controversy while he's been in Smoky Mountain Wrestling, him and Ronnie Garvin at each other's throat, tooth and nail.
Well, I tell you, the crowd, Dutch, right now, they're really upsetting Orndorff, and that's because they're calling him Paula instead of Paul. You're talking about Danny Davis. You know, it was really great to see him back after being out of action several weeks, and it was all because of a pile driver by that man in the ring right now, Paul Orndorff.
Well, let me say one thing. Danny Davis, if he can't take the heat, he needs to get out of the kitchen. And I don't think he was invited out here. Bob, this is my time out here. This show is
I'm
my show.
I'm telling you all to shut it up. I'm sick and I'm tired of hearing Paula.
Well, I think Mr. Wonderful has just about lost it up there in the ring, Dutch.
Well,
from Atlanta, Georgia, 250 pounds, Mr. Wonderful, Paul Orndorff.
You know, his mind needs to be on business, Dutch. It needs to be on the opponents. It needs to be on Reno Riggins. He doesn't need to be worrying about what the crowd's saying and what the crowd's hollering to him.
Well, yes, he does in a way because what he does, he has to deal with almost a hostile crowd every night, everywhere he goes. When people are standing out there and they're shouting, Paula, 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 a feminine name for a masculine man, then I think that would cause him to back up and become disconcerted in his thinking.
You mentioned that we're going to be seeing more or again some of what happened here with Brian Lee, and as you call him, the master, is Kevin Sullivan. I call him a deranged Kevin Sullivan. I think he ought to be in a cell somewhere with padded walls. That's what I think Kevin Sullivan and where I think he should be. But Dutch, I never seen anything like what happened last week right here with that wild man.
Whoa!
Beautiful drop kick.
This Reno Riggins looking pretty good here. Looking very good. Wait a minute. We have a visitor at the desk here.
Yeah, here comes Ronnie Garvin. Let me get you a headset over here, Ronnie. And hey, tell you. I see one of your favorite guys up there in the ring, Mr. Wonderful.
Yeah, he's a very favorite fella. I just want you to do me a favor. This is going to be real short. I've got a note here.
Okay.
And whenever in the next hour, Mr. Paul Orndorff, Paula, better known as Paula, comes to the desk, Would you mind reading the letter?
Okay, you mean read it to him?
Read it to him.
Right, to her.
Read it to her.
Hey, I'll see that's you. You talking guy, not me. I'll be glad to read it to him, though. And Ronnie Garvin has left his Dutch. I don't know what's in this. I'm not going to open it. So,
let's read it right now.
No, let's wait till Paul Orndorff gets it. He wanted me to read it to Paul.
Well, all right, and fans, let's go back to the match here.
Look at Orndorff. He was into the ropes. He was so close to the corner there, Dutch, that when he went to the suplex, he went right into the turnbuckle. And the referee goes out of the ring to count out Reno Riggins.
Fans, your winner of the match, Mr. Wonderful, Paul Orndorff.
Well, against all odds, coming into this building here in a hostile crowd with the people yelling, Paula, Paula, and they're doing it right now, fans. Paul Orndorff has come out once again the victor right here on Smoky Mountain Wrestling.
All
let's
right.
take another look at it here.
Yeah, look at that again, Doug.
Let's look here. A vertical suplex right into the air. And, friends, this can hurt you because Reno Riggins' feet hit the rope, and it drives him right down on his neck. We see Paul Orndorff right now spinning over, and all he has to do is count. Let's go right now and talk to Paul Orndorff standing by with Bob Caudle.
All right, Dutch, and right you are. And, fans, here he is, Mr. Wonderful himself, Paul Orndorff. Paul.
You did say Paul, didn't you?
I said Paul.
Okay.
But that's not what the fans are saying.
No, I'm sick and tired of it. I'm sick and tired of hearing it.
Ronnie Garvin came out earlier. I don't know whether you saw Ronnie Garvin or not.
Who?
Ronnie Garvin, the man with the...
You mean the guy that stole that $15,000 robe? You know he did. And I want it back.
He's got it.
Yeah. Well, Danny Davis paid for the price too, didn't he? And everybody I step in the ring with is going to pay the price until I get that $15,000 robe back.
He asked me to read this note to you from Bob Armstrong, and it says, Dear Mr. Garvin, in response to your request of this past week, I agree that Paul Orndorff made a verbal agreement on TV last week.
I could beat Ronnie Garvin, I could beat Danny Davis, both at the same time. It's nothing to me.
Therefore, I am pleased to inform you that we have added a match to the Thanksgiving Thunder Tour schedule. Paul Orndorff versus Ronnie Garvin and Danny Davis in a handicap match. What about that, Paul? Yeah, a handicap match.
Maybe I'm a lot like Clinton. Says one thing and does another one, huh?
It's signed. It's sealed.
I didn't sign nothing. I don't know. Hey, how am I supposed to remember what I did a month ago? I don't know if I said that or not.
Handicap match.
I didn't sign nothing.
Thanksgiving Thunder, handicap match.
Well, big deal. So what?
You got to take them both on, right? In the handicap match. All right, fans, there it is. That's from Mr. Wonderful. You heard us. We'll be back. We're going to have more right after we take this time out.
I don't remember talking about it. I didn't sign up.
Fans, be sure to catch live Smoky Mountain Wrestling around the area in Barberville, Kentucky, Friday, December the 4th at the Knox Central High School at 8 p.m. Also, Clairfield, Tennessee at the Clairfield Elementary School, Monday, November the 23rd at 7 p.m. You'll see all the stars of Smoky Mountain Wrestling in 10 big matches, all seats only $6 in Clairfield. Also, Hurley, Virginia at the Hurley High School on Friday, November the 20th at 8 p.m. The Rock and Roll Express will be in Hurley. And it's Thanksgiving Thunder coming to Hazard, Kentucky at the Memorial Gym. Thanksgiving night, November the 26th at 7:30. It's WYMG night. All kids 12 and under get in for only 57 cents. You'll see Paul Orndorff against Dixie Dynamite. The Fantastics against Dutch Mantell and Jimmy Golden. Also, a 12-man Pick the Winner Battle Royal. One fan will win a portable stereo. Also, a lumberjack match. Thanksgiving night in Hazard. White Lightning and Tim Horner against the Dirty White Boy.
You know, Brian, the White Boy is running scared. You know, every time we meet, I can't seem to keep you around long enough to get some satisfaction, if you know what I'm saying. Well, in Thanksgiving Thunder, right there in Hazard, I'm going to get some satisfaction because you owe some debts and I'm going to collect. Right there in Thanksgiving Thunder. 8 guys around the ring, lumberjack match. Nowhere to go, White Boy. If you want to run out, somebody's going to throw you back in, and then I'm going to take it from there. You know what I'm saying? If you want to jump on me, jump on. And when you get tired, I'll take over.
It's Thanksgiving Thunder, Thanksgiving Night in Hazard. You'll see a match where falls count anywhere in the building between these guys, the Rock and Roll and the Heavenly Body.
That's right, falls count anywhere. Let me tell you something, Jim Cornette. Now, if we want to go to the floor, we won't get counted out, boy. That means we can beat you on the floor, up in the grandstand, anywhere it takes. Come on down to Heavenly Bodies. We got a match for you.
That's right, Thanksgiving Night. And I know it's a holiday that Jimmy Cornette loves because it's a day that you eat. You see, Jimmy Cornette, I come out here and call you anything in the world. But I cannot call you late for supper, Jack. But right here at Thanksgiving night, falls count anywhere in a building. Jimmy Cornette, everybody be at the supper table. We're going to be there because we are going to be the next Smoky Mountain Tag Team Champions.
All right, fans, with me right now, here's White Lightning, Tim Horner. Welcome, Tim. And I tell you, I've really been excited about Thanksgiving Thunder. I'm even more so now because I know you are, too, about a lumberjack match.
We couldn't be more excited than I am, Bob Collin, because I finally got the dirty white boy where I want him. You know, here lately, he's been running. He's been hiding behind Ron Wright, hiding behind Smoky Mountain Wrestling. He don't want to get in the ring. I have to chase him everywhere. You know, he broke the bottle and tried to hang me and everything. Well, I'm going to get my dues, and he's going to get his in Thanksgiving Thunder. And I can't wait because it's a lumberjack match. Eight guys around the ring, dirty white boy. Run if you want to, hide if you want to, but they're going to throw you right back in there to me. I may throw you out just to get to throw you back in, but nevertheless, when I come up there and I come into Thanksgiving Thunder, there's going to be a whole lot of thunder and a lot of lightning.
All right, fans, that's it. And boy, it's Tim Horner looking forward to Thanksgiving Thunder, as we are, and I know all you wrestling fans are. Talking about wrestling, let's go to the ring right now for more action.
Introducing at a combined weight of 425 pounds, Paul Lee and Jeff Daniels.
Well, Bob, this is...
The Stables old record song. Now, I sit and listen to them by myself.
Well, that's just as you heard to say, of course, is tag team action, and it's featuring one of the favorites as you see them now making their way into the ring area. One of the favorites of all time in tag team wrestling. Here they are, none other than Ricky and Robert, the Rock and Roll Express.
Yeah, but the question remains is, how well is Robert Gibson's hand? His hand injured at the hands of Jimmy Cornette and the Heavenly Body. Let's see how his hand fares in this match.
Introducing at a total weight of 448 pounds from Memphis, Tennessee, Ricky and Robert, the Rock and Roll Express.
All right, Rock and Roll Express right here against Paul Lee and Jeff Daniels, fans. And
you know,
it's gotta
Bob,
be Paul
I listen,
Lee that will start.
I
yes,
listen,
sir, Doug.
I listened to that interview with Tim Horner, and he's got an awfully big mouth. He is trying to stack the deck against the dirty white boy, but it's going to backfire in his face. Now let's get to this match
Doug,
right here.
Everything that the dirty white boy has done to him, hit him in the head with a beer bottle, hung him from the rope with his hands handcuffed behind him, any number of dirty deeds that he has done. There goes Lee into the corner, cut that somersault right on out of the ring, and onto the apron, comes right into the big right hand of Ricky Martin.
Well, we've seen Paul Lee here before. This is our first look at Jeff Daniels.
Hey, Dutch, I want you to notice, and all you fans to notice, too, that Robert Gibson's hand is still taped up, and that's after the attack that he had on that hand by the Heavenly Bodies. Dutch, you'll remember, and I know a lot of our fans will, when he had Gibson down in the ring, and they were just stomping and taking the tennis racket to the hand, anything they could do to that hand to try to injure it, I think to really put him out for Thanksgiving Thunder. Cornette didn't want to face these guys.
Well, I think it's a very strategic move on Jimmy Cornette's part to try to eliminate one of the members of the Rock and Roll Express. Now, I'm going to give credit where credit's due. The Rock and Roll Express have met a phenomenal amount of success in the wrestling profession, as has Jimmy Cornette and the Heavenly Bodies and all the other teams he's had. But right. Anytime Jimmy Cornette can get a chance to put Robert Gibson or Ricky Morton out, believe me, that chance will be taken.
All right, the Rock and Roll with a tag, and this is Robert Gibson, and he came in with a big, powerful knee lift that sent Lee really reeling. Hit the mat, and he hit it hard. Now here's Gibson in and off the ropes with a big block. It's been Paul Lee in since the opening bell. I think now he's going to try to reach back and get a tag. We're going to get our first look now, Dutch, as you said, of Jeff Daniels.
Alrighty, fans, if we can get a close-up, let's see if we can, the cameraman can get a close-up of Robert Gibson's left hand, I think, taped up, and it's taped up for a reason, friends. It's taped up because Jimmy Cornette
and the Heavenly Bodies, that's right,
really worked with that hand.
Just about crushed it. Hey, Dutch, the four faces of fear at Thanksgiving Thunder could be one of
are both of these teams in that. The four most dangerous matches in wrestling, four nights in a row. Never before has it been done. That'll be the end, I think, of either the Heavenly Bodies or the Rock and Roll, or maybe both of them.
Your winners of the match, the Rock and Roll Express.
Well, the Rock and Roll Express continuing their ways toward Thanksgiving. Let me say one thing about the Rock and Roll. The Rock and Roll, they can either put up or shut up there, because the title is on the line every night. Four faces of fear. Right now we see the Rock and Roll doing the signature move, the double drop kick on Jeff Daniels. Flash Morris down the referee to count. 1, 2, 3. A big win for the Rock and Roll right here on Smoky Mountain Wrestling. Let's go right now to Bob Caudle standing by with Jim Cornette and the Heavenly Bodies.
All right, Dutch, and right you are. And fans, here they are, the Heavenly Bodies. Jim Cornette, we just talked about and we mentioned the four faces of fear in there, Jim Cornette.
Yeah, hey, you want to know what the face of fear is? Look at the faces on these people. This crowd looks like a giant casting call for the part of Boo Radley in the remake of To Kill a Mockingbird, but that may be too obscure a reference for this clientele, right, Stan?
You know, some of the end of November is a time of giving thanks. And believe you me, Jim Cornette's Heavenly Bodies have plenty to be thankful for. We're the best-looking team in professional wrestling. Every morning we get up and look in the mirror and see that we're better looking, and we're thankful for that, Bob Caudle. We're also thankful because we're the champions. We got the gold, and the most of all, the most important thing that we're thankful for, Mr. Caudle, is the fact that we're going to put an end to the Rock and Roll Express for good. Right, Tom?
You see, for 4 days of Thanksgiving Thunder, your lives are going to be complete and total hell, Ricky Morton and Robert Gibson, because for 4 days, four continuous days in Thanksgiving Thunder, we can either rub your face in barbed wire, we can destroy you in a Texas death match, or we can take you where falls count, wherever we want in the building. And we will, at Thanksgiving Thunder, we will end the Rock and Roll Express career once and for all.
Bob Caudle, Friday night, Thursday night, Friday night, Saturday night, Sunday night, November 26th through 29th, Hazard, Kentucky, Welch, West Virginia, Johnson City, Tennessee, Knoxville, Tennessee, one place or another, Rock and Roll Express, you're going to play the part of Napoleon, and we're going to be Waterloo.
All right, fans. Thanksgiving Thunder, what an event it's going to be. We'll be back. We'll have more right after this.
Welcome to Down and Dirty with Dutch. I'm Dutch Mantell, and you're not. This is a special edition of Down and Dirty with Dutch. My special guest is Commissioner of Smoky Mountain Wrestling, Bob Armstrong. And we're going to talk in depth about the incident that happened last week between primetime Brian Lee and the Master, who has later revealed himself to be Kevin Sullivan. We're going to be showing some footage of that, but this is a disclaimer. This is a warning. This is graphic footage. We have censored it because we have had some complaints on it. Let's see the incident that happened last week between primetime Brian Lee and the Master, and when we come back, I'll be talking to Commissioner Bob Armstrong.
Here he comes. Still don't know who he is. That's about as weird an entrance as the music, I would say. All in black with that robe, crawling there into the ring.
So this is the man who's caused Brian Lee so much grief, pain, and anguish over the past 3 months.
The Master, who in the heck can it be? We still don't know, because we still haven't seen him, but boy, Brian Lee is ready.
Fans, his opponent from parts unknown, weight unknown, the Master.
And look at Brian Lee, Dutch. He wants to see that face. As we say, he's waited for almost 3 months to meet him face to face, the guy that has caused him so much trouble and so much pain. Oh! And Brian Lee came charging into the corner after him, and you just saw the Master with some kind of fireballs right into the chest and the stomach.
Oh, what's he got?
Brian Lee, and he's got some kind of a spike, and it's Kevin Sullivan. This guy's criminally insane anyway. What the heck is he doing in the ring?
Well, here's the man who's called himself the Master, and obviously Brian Lee didn't know who it was. Now we see the Disciples joining in, the Night Stalker and Molokai, the Grim Reaper.
And there goes the referee down with that spike. Look at Kevin Sullivan now. He's got, it's a metal spike of some kind that he's driving right to the head of Primetime Brian Lee.
And he's opened him up. He's opened him up with that spike. And he's running it right into his forehead, right into his head.
This guy is Dutch. We've known Kevin Sullivan, and you've known him and seen him in action for a long, long time. Nobody's wilder, nobody's meaner, nobody's any more. The guy will do anything.
There's somebody coming to the ring to help out.
Paul Lee, he's out.
Paul Lee.
They've got him hung in the corner now.
And the
there's
master.
Brian Lee in the corner. Look at the master. Just keeps charging in.
The master is going.
He's still got that spike in his hand. The bell is sounded. It's all over. Here comes Robbie Eagle down to try to help.
They continue the onslaught on Brian Lee.
I've never seen anything like it, Doug. Three of them in there with Brian Lee. Look at that spike. Look well, what Sullivan is doing.
They fully intend to injure Brian
something's
Lee.
Something's got to happen here. Somebody's got to stop this. Somebody's got to call the law or something, Dutch.
Well, there's another guy. There come Robbie Eagle trying to get back into the ring. Paul Lee is out. Nobody can get in the
go
ring.
Go get the army. Get somebody in
wait
here.
Wait a minute. There's a cameraman. There's a cameraman up there. And he's off the apron. Now, what is he doing up there? He's got to be insane.
Well, he sees that Brian Lee is about to be slaughtered over there in that corner. Somebody's got to do something. We got to.
Bob, hang on now. What are you doing? What are you doing, Bob Caudill? Ladies and gentlemen, Bob Caudill has left the table. There he goes to the ring. Bob, you idiot, get back here before they drag you out here on a stretcher. Step back, Bob. What is wrong with this guy? These guys, he leaves me over here like the idiot he is. I hate to call him an idiot, but only an idiot would go to the ring with this going on. They've got guys trying to get into the ring. The Night Stalker is kicking them off. They got Brian Lee down over there. Kevin Sullivan, the master. That's Brian Lee. Bob, come back over here. Brian Lee is bleeding, ladies and gentlemen, like a stuck pig. He is really bleeding over there in the corner. Bob, come back over here before somebody comes out, Bob. Here come the troops now. Here come the troops. Bobby Fulton down. Jackie Fulton down. Nobody can get in the ring. These are big men knocking them off. There's a Night Stalker knocking Dixie Dynamite down again. Nobody can help Brian Lee. There's the spike. Kevin Sullivan continues with the spike. We see the blood. He's opened him up. Brian Lee, this is a very serious, serious thing.
After him, they got him. He's laying there. He's severely hurt. Blood's all over the place. He's laying there. They got a stretcher. Here, it's just bizarre. I wish you hadn't come to the ring, Bob. You could get hurt doing that. I tried to grab you, but see, this is between them.
All right, let's hear from the commissioner.
I made this mistake. I let this master, who turned out to be Kevin Sullivan, one of the most dim-witted idiots in the world, look what he did to this man. Well, I'm going to tell you, I'm going to correct my mistake that I made, brother. You are banned from Smoky Mountain Wrestling, you son of a for the rest of your life.
All right, if you heard it, that he is banned. From Smoky Mountain Wrestling. We won't see any more of him.
I disagree with a lot of Bob Armstrong, the commissioner's decision, but I sort of have to agree with him on this. This is totally out of hand. This is bizarre. It should never have happened.
Yeah, you're right, Doug.
That was very graphic footage, Mr. Armstrong, and last week I apologized to all the fans. The whole show became out of control, and I don't blame you for your action in suspending Kevin Sullivan.
But let me think about this just a minute. I've thought about it all week, and let me put it this way to you. I've done a little research, and I found out Kevin Sullivan, the reason he had such a bad grudge against us as a whole, Smoky Mountain Wrestling and myself, is because when we first started, Kevin Sullivan wanted to come in here and wrestle. But you know as well as I do, Dutch, he had a bad reputation. Mm-hmm. He can't even wrestle in this country. That's why you don't see him on TV anymore. He has to go overseas to wrestle. So I didn't want him here. I didn't need another problem. So he held this grudge, and he finally picked his chance. And I feel responsible because I let him come back here and wrestle Primetime Brian Lee. And when I entered that ring last week and I saw what a bad condition Brian Lee was in, he was stitched up, bleeding, I did lose control. I apologize for that. Now, I'm going to ban him from TV right off the bat. I'm not going to take that back. But if he wants to be so bad as to come in here and wrestle somebody, I don't want him to get away with what he did. He's come in here. He's laid Primetime Brian Lee out. I mean, no telling how long he'll be out. He's hurt bad. And he's leaving to get away with it. I ain't going to go for that. Mm-hmm. He's going to pay for it. And I'll tell you why. Because I know a man that is just as big and bad, who's been suspended for more territories than any human being. And I know that he's bad because I've had personal experiences with him. He can chop you down like a big oak tree with them big hands of his, and I know he's one of the meanest men. So, Kevin Sullivan, if you want a part of this, If you want to get part of the real bad men in this wrestling organization, Thanksgiving Thunder, you're going to see the baddest of them all, and I know. Let's take a look at the Mongolian Stomper.
Wham! Got him right in the head. That Stomper shows no mercy. Referee goes one, two. Bob Armstrong kicks out of it. The Stomper with a look on his face saying, my gosh, how did he do it? Bob Armstrong really wham, really took some mighty mean kicks to the head like that. Armstrong, I think he's bleeding. I think Bob Armstrong, yes, he is. Bob Armstrong is bleeding. Apparently that kick in the head busted his head open. And a Stomper right now just got to keep on in there. Bob Armstrong, and boy, is he ever bleeding. A Stomper kicking on Armstrong now. Bob Armstrong may be in trouble because he is covered with blood. Now choking. Referee orders the break. Wham. Look at that. You might be able to see the blood on the Stomper's right leg and on his chest. That is the blood from Bob Armstrong's head. Wham. Bob Armstrong just pounding it. Look at the blood on him. My gosh. Now Bob Armstrong just trying to fight a hunk of flesh out of the Stomper's head. Look at that. Armstrong working away. Pounding away. The Stomper, I believe, is bleeding. He's not bleeding. He has a lot of Bob Armstrong blood. The Stomper is bleeding. My gosh, is he ever. Oh, fans. Wait till you get a look at the Stomper's face. Boy, those wrestlers have gone berserk in that ring.
Well, after watching that footage, Mr. Armstrong, I can say that you two guys looked as bad off as Brian Lee did last week.
Well, that's exactly what I meant by personal experience. Now, I called the Stomper. He's so bad, I don't even like to talk to him over the phone. It's the first civil conversation I've ever had with him. But I wanted to correct a wrong that I felt I had caused, and I wanted to make sure I had his word that he'd be here on Thanksgiving Thunder. And Kevin Sullivan, you talking about bad. B is in bad news, A is in atrocious, and D is in disaster, destruction, and devastation. You're going to find out at Thanksgiving Thunder, because the big bad Mongolian Stomper's going to leave you looking twice as bad as prime time.
Well, there you heard it, fans. Commissioner Bob Armstrong, it's getting heavy, and it's getting hot in Smoky Mountain. Stay tuned. We'll be right back.
WIMT invites you to attend Smoky Mountain Wrestling's Thanksgiving Thunder Thursday, November the 26th at Memorial Gym in Hazard. Jim Cornette's Heavenly Bodies defend the tag titles against the Rock and Roll Express and Falls Count anywhere in the building. Tim Horner faces the Dirty White Boy in a lumberjack match for the title. Kevin Sullivan faces the Mongolian Stomper returning to Hazard. A Pick the Winner Battle Royal. One lucky fan will win a portable stereo. Four more matches. Kids under 12 get in for only 57 cents. That's Thanksgiving night in Hazard.
Fans, Smoky Mountain Commissioner Bob Armstrong has banned Kevin Sullivan from appearing live on television, but he couldn't legally stop him from buying time on the program. Therefore, before this segment, I must read this disclaimer from Smoky Mountain attorney Christopher Capps of Capps, Cantwell, and Capps in Morristown, Tennessee. This is a paid commercial announcement. Smoky Mountain Wrestling is not responsible and does not necessarily agree with or condone any viewpoints expressed by Kevin Sullivan. Now, let's go to the tape.
Please allow me to introduce myself. I'm a man of wealth and taste. I've been around for a long, long year. Stole many a man's soul and faith.
Look, look, it's the master, he's coming.
Bob Armstrong, Commissioner Bob Armstrong, the cartridge of Brian Lee belongs to you. The busted, twisted body belongs to you. It is on your head that it rests. You see, Commissioner Armstrong, if it wasn't for my benevolent self, he would be hooked up to an embalming bottle. All I ever wanted, Commissioner Armstrong, was a chance to come into Smoky Mountain Wrestling. But no, you said, just like the other federations, I was too violent. Commissioner Armstrong, it was never proven. It was never proven. It was allegations, lies, and innuendos. You see, Commissioner Armstrong, this is just the beginning. You see, wrestling has gone through a change. They want to sanitize wrestling. Get the violence out of wrestling. Make it a kiddie show. Well, I'm not for kids, you see. You see, Bob Armstrong, this is the face of a man that was sent to the sea of exile, strapped to the tree of woe, and told never to return. That I was not a good influence, Bob Armstrong. That men like Brian Lee were the type of people that the children and the rest of society could look up to.
No.
That I and my followers are the type of people that is what's wrong with this society today. Commissioner Armstrong, it is because of you and people that pass judgment is why I'm here. You see, Brian Lee is not the first. They can sanitize wrestling all they want, the big organizations. But this is Smoky Mountain Wrestling.
Smoky Mountain.
This is where it's all real, Commissioner.
Real.
Starting from me. I told you what I was going to do. And now, it's Thanksgiving Day Thunder.
Thanksgiving.
Thanksgiving Day Thunder, a day that I love. I love thunder. I love lightning. I love it when the moon is full and people howl. You see, Bob Armstrong, you've made another mistake.
Mistake.
Peace has spread out among the land. The Cold War's over.
It's over.
You've reached over to an old enemy who's become a friend. You've grasped his hand and said, there is no more Russia, there is no Mongolia, there's just peace. Mongolian stomper, at one time you were a warrior. At one time you knew the taste of blood, stomper.
Blood?
At one time your heart ran black and cold. Thanksgiving night, Thanksgiving Day Thunder, stomper. I'm gonna show the people you are no longer the warrior.
No longer.
But an errand boy.
Boy.
For the commissioner. Commissioner, the difference between you and myself, my followers believe in me. They believe that with me, they will reach the promised land. And that is sitting on top of Smoky Mountain Wrestling. And the sins that we commit will be on your head.
Pleased to meet you. Hope you guessed my name.
Introducing first from Raleigh, North Carolina, 236 pounds, here is Robbie Eagle.
All right, fans, Robbie Eagle in the ring. Wild, wild music, of course. Dutch is ringing into the ring area right now. The wild-eyed one himself. Here he is, Tracy Smothers, the wild-eyed Southern boy.
Well, there he is. Ain't no telling what this guy's doing. He's from Springfield, Tennessee.
and he's waving the flag around, and he's made a pretty fair, decent impression so far as Smoky Mountain Wrestling, but the question remains, can he keep it up?
Well, he's been on a real tear. You're aware of that, and I think most of the fans are, too, since coming to Smoky Mountain Wrestling. As a matter of fact, Dutch, he's undefeated in Smoky Mountain Wrestling.
Well, let's hear the introduction, ladies and gentlemen. Brian Matthews, the voice of FM 94 in Marion, Virginia.
Fans introducing from Springfield, Tennessee, 235 pounds, the wild-eyed Southern boy, Tracy Smothers.
All right, the young man here, as we say, that's really been on a tear in Smoky Mountain Wrestling. A lot of energy in the ring. He bounces into the ring. He's ready to go at the bell, and he's all business inside that ring. By the way, Dutch and fans, this is something I want all of you fans to know. All you fans in Knoxville, Tennessee, you can get two free tickets to Thanksgiving Thunder November 29th at the Coliseum and save 25% on your first month's rental on any new monthly rental from Spectrum Rents, three Knoxville locations. The Pick the Winner Battle Royal Prize for Lucky Fan on November 29th is an RCA Color Track TV. Dutch, believe it, it's worth almost $500.
Can I enter?
You cannot enter that, Dutch.
Why not?
With all your money, you don't need to win anything,
okay,
Dutch.
Fans, let's get a good look here at Tracy Smothers. He's talented, he's big, he's strong, he looks like he's in shape.
Doesn't only look like it, he is. Look at that. From a standing flat foot, high with that drop kick right on the chin of Robbie Eagle, and then that good arm drag and that takedown. Dutch, that tape we just saw now, you got to agree with me. Don't you think that proves that Kevin Sullivan is sick, that he really shouldn't even be allowed in wrestling at all? He's got to be a deranged, sick individual. He needs to be looked after. He needs to be put somewhere.
Two! Oh, what some shots by Robbie Eagle on Tracy Smothers.
And he's going to whip him all the way across the ring, but he's going to miss that. Smothers ducked right out of that corner. Watch out. Here comes that clock. You never did answer me about that. Sullivan.
About Kevin Sullivan. Well, yeah. I'm going to tell you, very few people scare me, but he sort of shakes me up a little bit.
He's got the big hook. He's got it covered. 1, 2, 3. What about that one, Dutch?
Your winner of the match, Tracy Smothers.
Okay, Tracy Smothers with a big win here on Smoky Mountain Wrestling. I think Tracy Smothers, he may make some people back up and take a different look at him. Off the top rope, a big, big elbow right there to Robbie Eagle. He's down. And Tracy Smothers continues his winning ways right here on Smoky Mountain Wrestling. The referee slides in. 1, 2, 3. And all right, fans, here's some more information on the Thanksgiving Thunder Tour.
The Smoky Mountain Wrestling Thanksgiving Thunder Tour is coming near you. Thursday, November the 26th in Hazard, Kentucky at the Memorial Gym. Friday, November the 27th in Welch, West Virginia at the National Guard Armory. Saturday, November the 28th in the Freedom Hall in Johnson City. And Sunday afternoon, November the 29th in Knoxville at the Coliseum. The feature event, a Pick the Winner Battle Royal. One lucky fan will win a prize, such as a VCR, color TV, or stereo. Tag team titles on the line in The Four Faces of Fear. The Rock and Roll Express versus the Heavenly Bodies. Thursday in Hazard Falls Count Anywhere. Friday in Welch, West Virginia, a Texas Death Match. Saturday in Johnson City, a Smoky Mountain Street Fight. And Sunday in the Knoxville Coliseum, a barbed wire cage match. Don't miss this challenge of The Four Faces of Fear. Also, Dirty White Boy defends the heavyweight title against Tim Horner in a lumberjack match. Selected cities on the tour will see Kevin Sullivan take on the Mongolian Stomper. Paul Orndorff versus Ronnie Garvin and Danny Davis in a handicap match. The Fantastics take on Robert Fuller and Jimmy Gold of the Stud Stable, and more at each stop on the tour. Thanksgiving Thunder is coming. Don't miss it.
Our dream match winner this week is Christy Newman of Knoxville, Tennessee, who wants to see the Fantastics versus the Stud Stable. And Christy wins a package of Smoky Mountain Wrestling souvenirs worth over $50 and is eligible for the all-expenses-paid trip to Thanksgiving Thunder in Knoxville, November the 29th, limousine tickets to the matches, and dinner with her favorite wrestler and more.
All right, fans. Now, next week, the dream match, get this one. The dream match, the Heavenly Bodies and Jim Cornette against the Rock and Roll Express and Bob Armstrong in a six-man tag. Now, Bob Armstrong felt that it would be a conflict of interest for him to wrestle, so he is designated as his replacement, Ronnie Garvin, the man with the hands of stone. So next week, the Rock and Roll And Ronnie Garvin, the man with the hands of stone, against Heavenly Body and Jim Cornette. Wait a minute.
What are you talking about? What is he trying to do?
Wait a minute.
You're going to get me killed.
All right, fans, let's. Wait a minute. Let's.
You can't put me in the ring with a gun.
Cornette's going crazy here. Let's go to the ring.
Kill somebody.
Robert Fuller and Jimmy Golden, the stud stable.
All right, and Dutch, you talked about them, and they're big, they're huge, they're rough, they're tough. What a team they are. But if anybody can take them down, it's this twosome right here, the Fantastics.
At a total weight of 460 pounds from the City of Angels, Bobby and Jackie Fulton, the Fantastics.
Well, fans, what we got right here is a number one contender match, the Stud Stable versus the Fantastics, only on Smoky Mountain Wrestling. Now, what was that deal you just read, Bob, about what? Armstrong, a conflict of interest. What was this?
Cornette liked to wreck us over there, didn't he? Well, you know, the dream match for next week, what the fans wanted to see was the Heavenly Bodies and Cornette against the Rock and Roll Express and Bob Armstrong. But Commissioner Armstrong, he felt like that'd be a conflict of interest, so he named Ronnie Garvin, the man with the hands of stone.
Next week,
yeah, Rock and Roll and Garvin against the Heavenly Bodies and Jim Cornette. That is, if Cornette doesn't have a heart attack in the meantime.
Well, I think Bob Armstrong doesn't like Jimmy Cornette and is using this opportunity to take out some frustrations on not only the Heavenly Bodies, but Jim Cornette personally.
All right, and here comes, of course, Luke Dutch moving in right here with us. Here's the Dirty White Boy and Mr. Ron Wright, the manager of the Dirty White Boy. And let's get them a microphone over there, Dutch, to talk about, I'm sure, that they're going to have a few words to say about the Lumberjack match with Tim Horner.
That's just some kind of gimmick that they've come up trying in another way to get my man down, getting four people out there to help hold a man in the ring to try to get Horner to get a victory over him. But let me tell you, we get to pick four men out of our stable, so we may not have four men out there that'll be man enough to throw my man back in the ring if he does get out.
Well, Horner's not going to pick it. He's not going to have
I've been chasing White Lightning Tim Horner all over every building, all over the east, north, south. I've chased him everywhere. This is the only way that I can get Tim Horner in the ring.
All right, now you two, while you're here, and we want you to look at the action in the ring, too, because this is a match that we wanted on TV for a long time. These two teams right here, they're trying to make it to the top and get the top contender spot for the tag team title. And that's two outstanding tag teams in the ring
right now. Well, you got half of it right. The Stud Stable is definitely one of the top contenders across the country anywhere. But these Fulton boys, I don't know about them. I could probably put this heavyweight title up and take them both on and beat them both right in the middle.
Now, is that confidence for you,
that's
Bob?
That's coming directly
from the Dirty White Boy.
All right, let me ask Mr. Ron Wright this question, because he's an expert on this. Do you think that Jim Cornette, now having to wrestle, is going to have any effect on him at Thanksgiving Thunder? He went wild out here a while ago.
Let me tell you, this Thanksgiving Thunder that they're pulling over on all of us is going to have a large, great, tremendous impact on wrestling all over the world, Mr. Caudill. You can bank on that.
All right, Dutch, and in the ring right now, here is Jackie Fulton. Down goes Jimmy Golden from that big block. You got two big men in there right now. And Fulton and Golden.
Pulling the tights, and Fulton boys, they're known worldwide for cheating.
Well, you see, any time you get the Fultons together, they're brothers, and they say blood is thicker than water, of course, but they cheat. They just try to pretend like they don't. They're pretenders. They're not contenders. They're pretenders.
Have you guys got any special things you're going to be doing, any special plans for the Lumberjack match?
Yeah, I'm going to go out there. I'm going to beat White Lightning Tim Horner's stinking brains out, pin him right in the middle of the ring, and then walk out the Smoky Mountain heavyweight champion.
Just like that.
It's simple. It's like going to the store, buying a gallon of milk. If you got the money, you can buy the milk. If not, get out of the store.
All right, absolutely. Hit scissors right there by Golden. And what about that, Mr. Wright?
I didn't really agree with this Lumberjack match and this whole week of this Thanksgiving Thunder they're calling it. That's not my ideal of professional wrestling, but if we need four men out there to keep Tim Horner throwed up there in the ring for my beloved Dirty White Boy to whip him, and that's exactly how the outcome of that thing will be. We'll keep him throwed back up in the ring where my man can manhandle Mr. Tim Horner.
All right, the referee's down in the ring right now. Hey, Bobby went right into the referee, and the referee's out. Dutch, he's down on the floor right
now. Where's that other referee?
We need to get him in the ring right now. We got all four guys in the ring. It's wild right now with no referee in there. They're doing that, Dirty White Boy. All four of them in the ring.
Wait a minute,
no
Bob.
Referee.
Look, I'm going to go to the ring. Do I have to do everything around here myself? I'm going to go to the ring. This match is too important without a referee.
What do you mean you're going? Dutch, you're no referee, Dutch. What the heck is Dutch doing going up there? He's going up there to try to get a little order, I hope, restored in this match up there. You see Dutch fans timing right up in the ring. You got all four of them. And he stopped. Oh, my heavens. He grabbed Fuller by the arm, and Fuller got cocked with the right hand. He got between them. Dolan goes down from the right. Now what's going on with Dutch?
I thought he'd be a pretty good referee, but it looks like he's lost his mind.
No, he was trying to get order restored, and the Fultons just were able to take advantage of it. It looked like to me a double team. Fuller coming off of the ropes with a snap mare. Down he goes with those elbows.
That man up there, he shouldn't be allowing that.
Well, Dutch is up there trying to get some order. It looked like, what the heck, is he going to count him out? One, two, oh, and he kicked out. Two, says Dutch.
I don't understand what's going on.
I don't understand this at all with Dutch up there. A good high drop kick right there from Bobby Fulton.
Yeah, but if you notice, he kicked him with the tips of his boots, which is a toe, which is very illegal in professional wrestling.
Look at him now. They're just, this could be the finish right here. They could wrap him up. That could be all for Fuller.
Heck, it's broken out in there again with all four guys.
I thought Dutch might try to get a little order or get some order restored. He hadn't had much success at it. Foley goes down from a big boot over in the corner. And Bobby Fuller just kicking and stomping and flailing away.
The top rope.
And Robert Fuller. Hey, wait a minute.
Did you see the quickness of Jimmy Golden?
Did he do that on purpose?
Did you?
What a count.
Oh, now right there is a true referee. And the quickness
Holy
of Jimmy
cow.
Golden.
One,
I can't believe it. It's beautiful.
He jerked
beautiful.
Away. It's all
Ron, what do you
did
think?
That quick. Did he do that on purpose? I don't know, fans. We'll be back.
It's live Smoky Mountain Wrestling action around the area, Barberville, Kentucky, Friday, December the 4th at the Knox Central High School at 8 p.m. Clairfield, Tennessee, the Clairfield Elementary School on Monday, November the 23rd at 7 p.m. All the stars of Smoky Mountain Wrestling in 10 big matches, all seats only $6 in Clairfield. Hurley, Virginia at the Hurley High School, Friday, November the 20th at 8 p.m. You'll see the Rock and Roll Express in Hurley. And it's Thanksgiving Thunder coming to Hazard, Kentucky at the Memorial Gym, Thanksgiving night, November the 26th at 7 p.m. It's WYMT night in Hazard. All kids 12 and under get in for only 57 cents. You'll see the Fantastics take on Dutch Mantell and Jimmy Golden. A lumberjack match with White Lightning and Tim Horner against the Dirty White Boy. A 12-man pick the winner battle royal. One fan will win a portable stereo. A falls count anywhere in the building match between the Rock and Roll Express and the Heavenly Bodies. Kevin Sullivan taking on the former Southeastern Heavyweight Champion, the Mongolian Stomper. And this man, Mr. Wonderful, Paul Orndorff, in Hazard, taking on Dixie Dynamite.
You know something, I could think of a lot of other places that I would rather be than in Hazard, Kentucky. A coal mining town. You know, it doesn't take a lot of intelligence to go down in a buggy 2 or 3 miles in the ground and come out. I'm telling you one thing, when Mr. Wonderful comes to that town, I'm going to take care of some business on my own. If Ronnie Garvin was all the man that he says he is, he wouldn't be sending this little Dixie Dynamite punk to face Mr. Wonderful, the man who rules Smoky Mountain Wrestling. And then I hear the kids get in for 57 cents. I better not hear those little curtain climbers hollering Mr. Wonderful or getting on to my case. Because Dixie Dynamite, when it's all over and done with, I'm going to stick you just like I did Danny Davis. And you people out there saw just a week or 2 weeks ago what I'd done to him. And Ronnie Garvin, this whole thing, you and I, sometime, someplace, we're going to be in Hazard, Kentucky. And when it's done, the same thing's going to happen to you.
All right, fans, these three right here are looking forward to that six-man tag team match with the Heavenly Bodies and Jim Cornette. Right,
Ronnie
Garvin?
Next week, we're going to have us a party next week. Personally, I've got one thing in mind. I'm going to take care of Jim Cornette while my two partners here are going to take care of the rest.
That's right, Bob. You know, Jimmy Cornette always come out here running his big mouth, telling the whole world what he's going to do to the Rock and Roll Express. But you see, Jimmy Cornette, we always have an ace in the hole. I'm talking about the hands of stone, Ronnie Garvin. So stick your nose in that ring, baby, and bam, one, two, three, out goes the lights, baby. Yeah.
All right, fans, it's the dream match, the six-man tag team dream match right here next week. We'll see you then, and until then, so long for now.